We don't insist that another world is possible. If we don't insist that there is an alternative to capitalism, we would be capitulating to capitalism. And as someone who has grown up in the movement, someone who has always been active in one way or another, I don't know how to behave any other way. You know, I don't know how to give up. I really don't. I don't know what I would do with myself if I decided, the old dreams we had of ushering into the world a sense of economic equality, economic justice, you know, racial equality, if we don't have the will to create that internationalism, largely because of the impact of neoliberalism and the individualistic responses that it encourages. Earlier I was saying that historical memory is important. And I think that the memory of that internationalism needs to be deployed in such a way that will encourage this upcoming generation to focus even more profoundly on the production of international solidarity. We hope to see young students challenging racism on university campuses and knowing how to make the connections between what is happening to them as students and what is happening in Black and Latino communities with respect to the police. Being able to make connections between the extent to which trans people are criminalized and subject to incredible violence. So I would say that my inspiration comes from the fact that I see a younger generation taking for granted what we struggle to try to understand. And that is what gives me hope.